Get ready to match the stars. Bert Convy. Red Summer. Nipsey Russell. Marianne Mobley. Richard Dawson. And Ann Elder. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 73. And here's the host of Match Game 73.
Hello there.
Hello.
Very nice.
How do you do?
Yay,
I would like you to join me in a brisk round of applause for Johnny Olsen. Johnny, come out here.
Johnny.
Step over here, John.
What is this all about?
This is for no reason at all. Just because I think you're a terrific guy.
Thank you very, very much, dude.
Let's be truthful.
What's that? What's that?
We'll be truthful. What? There is a reason.
There is a reason.
You've been fired.
Thanks a lot.
That's, we couldn't do it without Johnny Olsen. That's the only reason I had in mind. Okay, thank you, John. Let's say hello to Loretta Slavery and Robert Spencer, our two players here. Now, we know that Robert Spencer is our current champion. He's won one game and got $600. Does that make you happy?
Very happy.
Well, I'm very happy that you're happy. And Loretta Savory is going to challenge you. And would you tell us a little bit about yourself?
I'm from Rutherford, New Jersey, and I'm a music major at Rutgers University.
Rutherford, New Jersey! And you're a music major?
Yes.
Well, that's a beautiful part of America. Rutgers, where that whole historic place. We'll start this game right after we present these massive whatever. There you are. Okay, we're going to start a brand new game here with Loretta Savory and Robert Spencer, Jr. And Loretta, you know that you and Robert will be answering questions, trying to match our six celebrated individuals over there.
Yes, sir.
And the one who does that most often at the end of the second round will be the winner.
And
wins $100 for doing that, and then has a go at the super match where you can win $5,000.
Sure.
All right, challenger, enough. Would you make a selection?
B, please.
Loretta wants B. Are you ready for Loretta?
Ready.
Okay.
I'm ready for B.
Are you ready for Loretta?
Harry.
You
says here, Harry. I'm reading right here. It says Harry. The printing is getting smaller.
Helen Keller reads the
Harry
question.
Had to buy an extra large bed to make room for his extra large blank. We got a cackler in the audience, John. Some lady out there. You better get her for one of our future shows. Everybody hear that? Harry had to buy an extra large bed to make room for his extra large blank. Bottom tier is ready, and we're waiting for Nipsey.
Nipsey's always been poking.
There we go. He's all set now. So we'll call on Loretta Savory to give us a response to this. Harry had to buy an extra large bed to make room for his extra large...
Wife.
Wife. Okay. You know who Harry was married to, according to her. But what do you say, Bert?
I say Harry was married to old Fatso and his wife.
Wife is your answer, and that's yours. There's a match. Now, Brett?
Well, it's not that I'm so extra large. It's that I take a lot of room in the bed. That's why Jack has moved elsewhere. Wife.
Wife. Very well done, Loretta. You're up to two. What do you say, Nipsey?
Harry's wife looked like a bale of hay with the middle band busted, but I thought...
Big feet. Your artwork is terrific. What do you say there?
Well, I thought he had a very large wife.
Another match for you, Loretta. That's three. Okay.
She was so large, she fell down and rocked herself to sleep trying to get up. So I put wife.
That's it. An extra large bed to make room for his extra large...
Yes, a woman who took a bath every night in Lardettes. A wife.
A wife. Okay.
Bath every night in Lardettes.
Got all but one there, Loretta. Now let's see how our current champ does with this. Listen carefully, Robert. George had done almost everything.
There it is.
George, what?
What's that?
I couldn't get my pen out. It was stuck in that little opening there.
Please don't talk when I'm talking.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It's my show, remember? Yes. Are you ready now?
Yes.
Is everything unloose? Okay.
Don't talk when he's at
all right. George had done almost everything, but he had never been to a blank in his life.
Huh?
George had done almost everything, but he had never been to a blank in his life.
I know how to do this. This goes off.
So you take the pen and you put it to the paper, and you move it and make these little symbols, which we will understand.
I think I'm just going to sit and fan.
No, fanning is not allowed.
Okay, now he had never been to a blank in his whole life.
Right.
George
had done almost everything, but he had never been to a blank in his life.
Okay.
Give up that accent, Marianne.
Just notice I'm sitting next to an amnesia victim.
Okay. Everybody's ready over there. Are you ready here? What answer do you think will match these assortment of kooks over here? George had done almost everything, but he'd never been to a blank in his life.
I'll say orgy or a love-in.
A love-in.
Or orgy.
An orgy.
Right.
Orgy.
Orgy, he says.
She's gone again.
She goes again. Well, let's move along here briskly. Well, orgy's his answer.
Orgy's his answer. This is in the general area. I said house of ill repute.
That's not necessarily an orgy.
Then you've never been to one, right?
No, that's right. Okay. Speak for yourself, Bert. Brett, what do you say?
That's right, dear, and I'll speak for you. I said... What did I say?
What did you say?
I thought of all the places he possibly couldn't have been to or hadn't gone, and I said strip joint.
A strip joint. Okay, that's your choice.
Joint?
His choice is orgy. Nipsey, yours,
because
please.
George couldn't find one, he'd never been to a nudist camp.
A nudist camp. Hey, there's another good answer, isn't it? What little gym...
Can I just pass?
No, you can't pass. You got to hold it up and say it out loud, too, so they can
She's
all hear out
She's
going
to say church,
there.
I know
oh,
it.
Oh, it's so boring.
Come on, Missy.
It was a clam bake.
You leave the room this minute.
It said
clam bake.
We hadn't done nothing in it.
That's right, no.
Clam bake. I know you were Miss America, but really.
All right.
I wanted to eat that card after I'd written it.
And we wanted you to eat it.
We may ask you to do that yet. Let's see what Richard Dawson has.
She did say clam bake, didn't she?
She said clam bake.
So sweet, I've gotten diabetes just sitting next to her.
The answer is orgy.
Orgy.
Clam bake. Yeah. Now, sweet little old demure Ann Elder, she wouldn't say a word like orgy, now, would she?
Well, if you're sitting next to Dickie Dawson, something rubs off. I said orgy.
Yeah. Okay.
I love that.
So, you've scored twice, and it's 5-2 at the end of round one. We go to round
five
two.
Five to two, I have to leave.
No, that's the score here. She's got five. He's got two. You made the selection. What'd you say? Speak up. Don't be shy just because you're in the presence of these crazy people over here. B is what now? Last time around, you matched five celebrities. And now you're going to try and match the one you didn't match.
Huckleberry Dillinger up here.
Nipsey Russell. You're the only one who writes.
Right, and I don't say words like orgy.
Right.
Why you say orgy? Have you never seen five people in love?
I'm still working on clam bake.
Yeah, give me press on here, Nipsey. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Would you listen carefully, because he's the only one writing. Patricia said, for some reason... Listen, would you listen to Patricia, what she says? She sometimes says something very important. Patricia said, for some reason, Carl likes to put on a blindfold before he blanks. You're on your own, Nipsey.
Don't touch Nipsey.
Now leave him alone. Now, Brett, you just leave him alone. It's his answer. That's it.
Don't do it, Nipsey.
Stay away from it, Nipsey.
Well, the moment of truth really is at hand.
Yeah.
We're going to find out if these two guys are really soul brothers.
No, they're not. Why did we write again, then?
Now, hold on now. No, it's Loretta's turn to give us a response now. Patricia said for some reason, Carl likes to put on a blindfold before he blanks. What do you say?
Goes to sleep.
Blindfold before he goes to sleep. All right. Show and tell, Nipsey.
Unless he can sleep in a plane. I said flies.
He flies. So there's no match there. And I guess we're going to have to pause momentarily here before we get to your end of the round, Robert. But you got your work cut out for you. You've got to match three celebrities, and we'll get to you right after we get to this. Please hurry back. There we go. 5-2 is the score in favor of our challenger, and we're going to complete our second and final round now with this assignment for Robert Spencer Jr., our current champ. You must match three. I say two.
You'll be all right when the plane lands.
You must match three celebrities. How many fingers in front of you? That's it. Okay. You know what you have to do, so what am I chopping my...
Please send your donation...
come on.
...to care of Save the MC, Match Game 72.
Everyone except Richard and Ann will participate
right,
in this.
They were the best.
Richard and Ann.
Yeah, keep them out.
Lay off.
Napoleon said... I keep my hand inside my lapel so I can hold on to my blank. Would you like to write an answer just for fun of it? No. Napoleon said, I keep my hand inside my lapel so I can hold on to my blank. What are you doing up there?
I was thinking, what was he holding?
Well, you think about it. Everybody ready? All right. Now let's turn to Robert Spencer Jr. here and find out how he responds to this. Napoleon said, I keep my hand inside my lapel so I can hold on to my...
pants.
My pants. I always thought he did look a little baggy pants in there. He's holding on to his pants. Holds up his pants this way, you see. And that's why he always walked funny, too. Huh? What did you say about this,
That's
Bert?
Exactly what I think. He's holding on to his pants.
There you go. You got one man. Two more. Tie the score.
Two more.
Two more to tie the score. Right?
Did Marianne Mobley really say clam bake?
Yes, she did.
Let's get on with this.
We're going to put you on the bus to Mississippi tonight, honey.
Under the bus.
Or under it. That's good. As I said, suspenders, does that count?
No. Nope. No match
all
there,
right,
I'm sorry to say. You must match Nipsey or you're out of it.
Am I out of phase? I thought Napoleon was a soldier, maybe holding his gun.
No, so there's no match there. And Loretta Fabry is our winner. Congratulations. You got $100 for winning the game. We congratulate you, and we thank you for being with us. You're not leaving empty-handed. You've got a little more money here to further your education.
Right.
May we wish you the best of luck
thank you.
The field of radio and television. Robert Spencer Jr., $600 winner. Step over here. That's it. You're wearing wedgies, aren't you?
Yeah.
You're almost as tall as I am, aren't you?
Just about.
Yeah. Okay. I'm not wearing mine. Well, listen now. You've got the $100 for winning the game, and now you're going to have a go at the super match. Here it is. You can win $5,000. Are you ready?
Yes.
We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their most frequent response to this. Blank booth. Blank booth. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. The second most frequent response, $250. And the third, $100. Get a little help here from three celebrities. Choose them one at a time and get their responses. Whom do you choose first?
Brett.
Phone booth.
Phone booth is what she said. All right. Another one?
Bert.
Oh, awesome. Who's the fellow that shot Lincoln? Is it Edwin?
John Wilkes.
John Wilkes. That's what I wanted to say.
John Wilkes.
Edwin was the father of the actor. That
right.
No, brother, dear.
His brother. That's
brother.
That's what I meant to say. It was
that's
brother.
Right. Okay, one
John
more.
Booth.
Marianne?
Toll booth.
Toll booth.
Yes, that's
good. Yeah.
You've got a phone booth, John Wilkes booth, and toll
Not
booth.
Too terrific, huh?
Now, you can... They're all
they
right.
They have them back east a lot.
They're a little hostile tonight, but they're restless.
Well, it's better than clam bake.
You may choose one of the answers the celebrities have given you, or give us one of your own. What would you like to do?
Phone booth.
Yes. Phone booth is the answer. That means you think phone booth is under the big money up there, right?
I hope so.
You hope so?
So do I.
Well, good luck to you. It's the answer that Brett gave you. We're looking for phone booth. Let's reveal it slowly. First, the $100 response. Ticket booth. Okay, not yet. Got two more chances. Looking for phone booth. Here is the $250 response. Shirley Booth. A marvelous actress.
How quickly they forget.
Yes, a darling lady, too. All right, one more chance. Looking for phone booth. Here is the $500 response.
Yeah. Phone booth. Telephone. You got it. Yeah.
Well done. Now, Loretta, you've got $500. That means you'll play for 10 times that amount, or $5,000. You can't collect that money, though, unless you match one celebrity on a head-to-head basis, and the match has to be an exact match when you work with one celebrity. Please choose one now.
Bert Convy.
She chooses you. Chooses you. Chooses.
Thank
chooses
God.
You. Now, Bert, you get ready to write. Will you just please face me this way? I'll get the $5,000 question. Write your answer to this, if you would, please, sir. On your blank. On your blank. The little chime indicated that Bert is finished, and now we need an answer from you. On your
life?
On your life, she says. All right, that's her answer. Bert, for $5,000, may we see your answer?
Yes, it was one of two or three, and I said on your mark.
On your mark. Did you think of that?
When it was too late.
Oh, you rejected that answer. Well, listen, you're up to a total of $600, and that ain't bad. And you're still a champ, and you're going to meet another player, and we'll play another game in a minute or so. But first, we've got a little message we want to pass along here. Then come right back. We're going to start a new game. That's where we are, folks. And we're going to say hello first to Joyce Nunley, and welcome her. Hi, Joyce. Where are you from, and what do you do and all that?
Well, I'm originally from New Jersey. I now live in Saugus, California, with my three daughters, and I teach teachers how to play games.
Really?
Really.
She teaches who?
May I inquire a little further as to what kind of games you teach teachers?
They are purely academic games.
Academic games.
Academic games, right.
Yeah. Come to my dressing room later, and we'll talk about it. No, that sounds like a very interesting occupation. You know that you and Loretta will be answering questions trying to match our six celebrities.
Right.
One who does that most often at the end of the second and final round will be the winner. Gets $100 for doing that, and then goes on to the super match where you can have a go at $5,000.
Okay.
Would you please make a selection?
Yes, I'll take B, please.
B, the natives are restless. We must move right along here. Yeah, I heard you yawning there. You rascal, you yawned, and I could hear you all the way over there.
I did not yawn.
Now, you better come up with a super-duper answer with this.
I yawned. He's
no. Oh, I see. Waldo said to the talent scout, I have a really fantastic act. I can hang by my blank. I don't write them. I just read them. That's all. Waldo's.
We heard you. Heard you.
You don't want me to repeat it, do you?
Not ever.
Okay. All right.
Waldo didn't say how long you could hang there, did he?
No.
Till his breath done.
All right, Joyce, would you please give us your response to Waldo said to the talent scout, I have a really fantastic act. I can hang by my
toes.
Toes. He says toes. You know, I've seen that in the circus, and it's really a remakable accomplishment when
really?
They hang
on the trapeze.
You don't want to hear about that either.
That's very, very interesting.
Really fascinating.
As a guy named Eunice can
say. Yes,
Bert, I've seen that fella hang up.
In the circus,
yeah. Yeah, hang by his toes. I've seen that, but did you ever see somebody hang by their tongues?
No.
Well, it's you said a fantastic act.
I've never seen that.
I know.
Brett,
I'm terrible.
What do you say, Brett?
Well, I certainly didn't say tongue. Can you see the pin that's in my gown?
Yes.
Well, I'll just put my finger there for the rest of the show.
Oh, no, I can't see the
pin. Oh, okay, I'll take my hand away.
Toes! That's the answer we're looking for, and that's what Brett comes up with. Now, Nipsey Russell, what do you say?
Maybe some people should be hung by their tongue.
Hung by the toes. Doing very well with that, Joyce. Here is Marianne Mobley.
I disagree with Nipsey. Toes.
Toes.
That's what I said.
He said toes.
I said toes.
What do you say, sir?
Suspended 100 feet above the arena, hung by his eyelashes.
Yep.
He killed himself when he blinked.
What do you say?
I say he hung by his...
Hung by his toes, and you're up to four matches. All right, we'll come right back right after this message. All right, we've run out of time, and we're going to pick up next time exactly at this point in the middle of round one, and it'll be your turn up, okay?
Come over here.
Well said.
You're
Dean.
Terrific.
Well said.
Listen, we'd like to hear a little bit about Bert Convy's new show.
I will.
Oh, thank you.
Would you like to tell us a little bit
about
it?
I'd love to tell you about it. It's called The Snoop Sisters. It'll be on NBC, 8:30 Wednesday nights this fall. And I get to work with Helen Hayes and
Yippee.
Lily Natwick and Lou Antonio, some wonderful actors.
Well, we're going to look forward to seeing that. Thank you very much.
I hope you do.
And we're looking forward to seeing all of you next time, whenever that is. Who knows? But our paths will cross again. Gene Rayburn saying so long for Match Game 73.
Today's consolation prizes are Charm Glowette, a completely portable gas grill that goes anywhere, instant flame without starter fluids or charcoal, Charm Glow products of Antioch, Illinois. And Long Nails, the amazing product that changes short, broken nails into long, beautiful, natural-looking nails with strength and glamour, Long Nails. This is Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game 73, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.